Gary, how you doing, mate? It is good to see you.
Good to see you, Richard.
It is quite the title, The Forest is the Path. It conjures up lots of imagery and metaphors. What does it mean to you?
I'm very deeply connected to the forest that's beside my house, but the name itself means, to me, I don't want it to mean, it doesn't have to mean this to anybody, but to me, I've felt lost in my life an awful lot, and not realized that maybe that's where I was supposed to be. So sometimes getting lost in the forest is exactly where you're meant to be.
It's been a while between drinks, but the record is fabulous. It's like catching up with an old friend again. Plenty of big anthemic tracks, a great vibe to the record.
Well, honestly, we didn't plan to make such a big sounding record, but it just sort of happened that way. We allowed all the songs just to happen whatever way they wanted to. And the first half of the record is kind of these huge choruses, which we're all okay with because we love playing some new songs live, and I think some of these are going to fit lovely into the set list.
When you're playing these big festivals, I mean, obviously the fans want to hear the stuff they know and love. You know, if you didn't play Chasing Cars, they'd chase you out of the joint. How hard is it to find the balance between playing the hits and weaving in the new stuff as well?
It's important to us because we've been going for 30 years, and I guess it might even be okay to run out of steam a little bit. Well, we don't feel like we've run out of any steam. We feel like we're actually more energized than ever. So we want to put new songs in the set. We want to make more albums. We've already written 10 new songs that we're going in to record in November. So things are kind of moving quite quickly, and it feels like we're just getting started in a way, you know, rather than sort of winding anything up. Show me a garden
that's bursting into life. You got a lot of fans here in Australia, of course. You're going to make us happy and come and see us again soon?
We've only obviously announced UK, Ireland and Europe so far, but we will be announcing more dates, and Australia will absolutely be front of mind for us because we love going to Australia, and we will definitely be there as soon as we possibly can. That's kind of given us a lot of energy as well, just the fact that there's plenty of people that, you know, promoters around the world that want us to come and play, and you know, it's always a good position to be in, rather than the other way.
Could you have dreamed back in the day when you were called Shrug and Polar Bear that 30 years down the track as Snow Patrol, you'd be talking about new music and future tours?
It blows my mind, really, because, you know, the first 10 years we didn't have any success, and then the last 20 we have. And we still, because of those first 10 years, we've never taken anything for granted. And to say I'm, like, happy to be here is the understatement of the year. You know, we're very, very lucky.
It must be lovely to have another hit album on your hands and to be getting such wonderful feedback.
The feedback's great. We don't know about hits just yet, but we will wait and see.
Well, you just enjoy those pats on the back, Gary. Lovely to talk to you, mate. We'll see you down here again soon.
Brilliant. Take care. Thank Cheers. You, Richard.
Big songs, aren't they? Snow Patrol's new album, The Forest is the Path, is out today.
30 years.
30 years, yeah.
Incredible career.